Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to share with you how I went about to build the example projects for the Chromium Embedded Framework, CEF, on my Windows 10 laptop. CEF is an open source software framework. As you can see, it's described that way on its Wikipedia page. And it's meant for embedding a Chromium web browser within another application. Typically, a C++ or C application can use CEF to have a built-in Chromium web browser. And it can use that then, the application can use that then to present a user interface that it supports the three OSs that I am interested in, Linux, Mac OS, and Windows. And it is based on Chromium web browser, which is the open source version of the Google Chrome browser. Let's go to the repository page for the example projects for CEF. This repository is hosted on Bitbucket, bitbucket.org, and it's the project, the main page on bitbucket.org is under Chromium Embedded, and the repo name is CEF Project. It's, as you can see, it's a very small set of top-level folders and files, and what it will build, it'll build some applications that it brings in from the main CEF repository, which is also hosted in a different place on bitbucket.org. Bitbucket.org, Chromium Embedded, CEF is where the source files, source code for the framework itself is there. You can also build the framework on your system if you're interested, and on any of the supported systems, apparently it's possible to build it. This particular project, the example project, is built so that it will download I think pre-built version of it for Windows when I try to build it on Windows. So, and what this project does, it pulls in some examples from CEF. The first example is called a simple application using CEF. And which is described in the tutorial page for CEF. So this is a tutorial page that is in the CEF repo, but it describes this simple app, which is basically shows how you can integrate a C application with CEF. And then there's another another example that is built is more in line with the topics that are described in the CEF wiki page for general usage. And so it goes into some more things that you can do in your application with CEF. With that, let's go to the setup requirements. So I went through the wiki page tutorial and then I came to this page, and as you can see, it requires CMake, and it requires Python. And specifically, it requires Python version 2.7, so you need to make sure that that's installed on your Windows 10 system or whatever system you're building on. So make sure that those tools are available on your system. In my case, since I'm not building at the moment in this video for Linux or Mac, I'm only building with Windows, I also need to make sure I have Visual Studio, which I do. I have the community version of Visual Studio 2019. So it's Visual Studio 2019 Community Edition. And it is a 64-bit. So I have this one, but the Community Edition, and it is a 64-bit. Version of Visual Studio 2019, and it's a 64-bit version of Windows 10 that I'm running on. Next step, after making sure that these tools are available, is to download the source code, or basically clone it. So here's the instruction on how to clone it. So in order to clone, I'm going to copy this path, and then go to this directory that I already created. I'm going to put it on in this location. So I'm going to use Tortoise and have Tortoise do the cloning for me. Since it's a pretty small project, it downloads pretty quickly. So then what I can do is I can come into Visual Studio Code now. So in Visual Studio Code, not Visual Studio, in Visual Studio Code, I just want to show you that, yeah, it was cloned, the repository for the CF project, and I can open it in Visual Studio Code. And we can look at some of the files that are there and that directory structure for it. And so as you saw, CMake examples, so it'll build a minimal example. This is the one that corresponds to the tutorial, and then some of the other ones are that it builds are corresponded to the general usage. And it also builds a static library that these applications actually use. But there's a CMake file, you can look at that, and there's a README file again on how to go about. This is the same README file that we were looking at before. So now I'm going to switch to the command prompt, and in the command prompt, let's make sure that you can see we can see the right version of Python. As you can see, that's Python 2.7.18, and my CMake is CMake version 3.19. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to that location, source, Bitbucket, embedded, and then CF project. So in this location, I need to make a build directory. Again, the instructions on how to do this are on the wiki page that we were looking at. Let's go back to that and take a look, and you'll see that the next steps are that we need to go to the project where the repository was cloned, make a build directory, go into the build directory, and these are the instructions for different OSs. So since I'm running on a 64-bit Windows and trying to build a 64-bit binary, I will just copy this path, this command, and that's the CMake command that I need to execute. So what I would do is I will come here, and so I did make the directory. I need to switch to that directory, and now I need to paste this command in here. So when I hit the enter, CMake will start to try to identify all the tool chains that are available. And as you can see now in this step, it identified that it's running Windows SDK 10, Microsoft Visual C 1928, and it also identified that it needs to go and download a CEF, the pre-built version of CEF. That's the most recent that it's compatible with. So as you can see, it's downloading. I'm going to let it finish downloading and then come back when it's done. So as you can see, it's still downloading. One thing I wanted to mention is that the command prompt I opened up is actually an x64 native tools command prompt for Visual Studio 2019. So it's not a simple standard Windows 10 command prompt. So it has all the setup that Visual Studio does for compiling programs with Visual Studio from the command line. So this is the command prompt that I'm actually using. So it's almost finished downloading the CEF pre-built package for Windows 10. And then what it's going to do is extract it and there is a warning here about CEF root environment variables not set. That's just a developer warning, and it can be silenced if need be, but it's safe to ignore that because it's able to go on without that. And again, it did detect Python 2.7.18, and it's downloading CLang format also from Google Storage. So here, there was the warning, and then it found Python, and then it downloaded CLang format. Now, if you happen to have a version of Python that is other than version two, like a Python 3 version, this will fail. This downloading of CLang format will fail from Google Storage somehow. When I tried it with Python 3, it failed, and only Python 2 is compatible with this Google Storage step. So then, after downloading the CLang format, as you can see, it's able to go and generate the Visual Studio 2019. It'll display some of the compiler capabilities. And now what it says is build files have been written to the build directory. And if we look at the build directory, we are in the build directory. As you can see, there is a file cef.sln. This file I can open in my Visual Studio. So as you can see, it has launched in Visual Studio, and it shows the example directory. And so here are the two sub projects. One is the CF Simple project, which is the simple application that goes with the tutorial wiki. This is the client app that is more for the so yeah, here's the main for the application. These are not command line applications. These are actually GUI applications. So, oh, here it is for CF Simple. It's also, as you can see, is a WinMain, and when it comes into WinMain, it will then start calling CF functions and is able to just basically use CF as a framework to run the message loop for the Windows application and receive keyboard and so on events. And then at the end, when it's closing, it'll use CF to shut it down. So these are the two Visual Studio projects that are part of this Visual Studio solution. And they depend on some of this other projects that came from CF itself. And there's some tests as well, and then there's this wrapper. But I did find one issue when I tried to build this. I'm going to let this build. I'm going to tell Visual Studio to build this, and it'll build it. It'll start building it, as you can see. But there will be there was a failure when I first tried it, and it had to do with the path that is by default CMake when it generates this project and this project. The linker, the path that it provides for the linker to find the CEF library is not correct. So I had to correct that, and I'll show you how that's done. But I'm going to let this build, and then we'll see if it'll hit that problem or not. Okay, it looks like it's finished, but as I mentioned, it will hit these two errors. And these two errors are being reported against Ceph Client and Ceph Simple. CF Simple and CF Client. So it's these two projects. And as you can see, it says it cannot find this libcf. The libcf does exist. If we go to the Explorer window, so libcf was downloaded in the and it was put into this third party library here. And as you can see, it exists here in the under the CF project repo, which is the sample projects, third party CF, CF, and this long directory name. And there's a copy of it in debug, and there's a copy of it in release. I happen to be building the debug version, so I know it exists. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just copy this path and bring it into Visual Studio and right click on the CF Simple, choose properties, and that way I can open the properties of that project. Again, for the debug configuration, which is the one that I'm building in this video, I want to come to the linker options, go to the input, and then as you can see, this first path is the one that has all those dots, and I want to replace this entire path with the path that I copied. But I want to make sure that I don't lose the backslash libcf.lib. So I gotta double check it, make sure after I just pasted the path that I had copied from the Windows Explorer, and so now I make sure that there is a backslash and there's a libcf.lib at the end. Otherwise, it'll still fail. And so I will click apply and click OK, and then go back. Now do the same thing for CF client. Right click on properties, and then come to the linker input. And this is for debug configuration. I am building the debug configuration, so in this video, so I won't bother with this release build. But if you're going to build the release version for yourself, then you need to do both, because apply this change to both, making sure that you have the right version of it. That is, for release, you want the release directory, and for debug, you want the debug directory subdirectory to be specified at the end of this path. But in any case, so here again, I'll make sure I have this backslash, and I have the name of the file, the library, and there's a semicolon that completes that. So I hit tab and then hit apply and hit OK. Now I should be able to build it and have it succeed. So I just right clicked and started the build. Okay, the build succeeded, and as you can see, there are no more errors. There may be warnings, but the output window is showing that it succeeded. Now both the CF Simple project and the CF Client projects are built, and we can try them out. Okay, now to launch the either CF Client or CF Simple, what I will do is I will come, pick one of the projects, and then go and say on the Project tab, I will say Set a Startup Project. Now when I hit, when I press Control F5, I can launch it, and as you can see, there's a browser page opened up. This is opened up by the CF Simple application, and it's a standard Google homepage. I guess you can type in some search items and so on, but this is a simple application. Just the purpose of it was to show that a C++ application can actually launch a web browser on its own. And then to start the other client, I will go and say pick CF client, and then go from project tab, and I will set it as a startup project. Then now when I say control F5, it will launch CF client. In this case, what you're seeing is a bit more features than the CF Simple. For example, you have these menus, the file menu, the help menu, the tests menu, and you also have the back button, the forward button, the reload, stop. You have an address bar where you can put some URL in there. But let's try some of these tests. I can zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom in, reset the zoom. And this is all, again, part of the C++ program application that launched this website. So, and then it has the elements that of an application. So it's presenting a user interface with a web view built in. Well, I hope this information was useful, and hope to catch you in the next video.